This video is around the presentation titled The Snapshot of Digital India by Ethinos Digital Agency, and we are going to be looking at some of the key highlights from this presentation. So in the first quarter of 2017, there was the Snap IPO, which did well, and also the stories feature driving spend by a large percentage. Instagram moon showing very rapid growth from 15 million to 25 million active profiles. These are numbers for India. And also Instagram and launched shopping ads, which helped users to share photos and videos in a single post. And they also release Instagram stories ads globally. So they've always had Instagram stories, but for the first time they allowed businesses to have ads around it. So stories as a feature has been tapped by WhatsApp, Snapchat, Instagram. I mean, they might call it differently, but essentially the core stories feature has done very well, and it's considered a very sticky feature by most analysts. And Twitter is now allows 280 characters from 140 characters. So these were some of the key highlights of 2017. The internet stats for India, for out of 1.34 billion, 462 million are already on the internet. So roughly one out of three in India is using the internet right now. In terms of total internet users, we are of course lagging China, which is at 738 million, and which is a very difficult lead to catch up with. Another interesting stats with respect to the age of internet users in India, and overall you can see that 72% of the internet users in India are less than 35 years old, which means that it is the perfect channel for businesses to target demographic, a youth oriented demographic. As you can expect, the growth in internet users would be coming from the rural segment in India. So from the 163 million, it's expected to go to 280 million in 2018, and that's a 40% year-on-year growth. What will the rural users be doing? Largely accessing social media. So in terms of businesses trying to, like FMCG and banking and telecom, who want to reach out to as many rural users as possible, the best bet would be to reach out to them when they are on social platforms, as the search, as social as accessing social media as a habit far outweighs the information search habit when it comes to rural India. Another interesting trend is the voice over long term. You can see the kind of growth that this technology is having, and we are at 2017, in the next 5 or 6 years this is going to really do very well. In India, this has been really brought into the forefront because of Jio, and cellular smartwatches are one of the latest devices to utilize this technology. So definitely something to watch out for in India, and from a business advertising point of view, this as a platform could be an important way in by which they could reach out to consumers by voice, because India is expected to have 800 million subscribers by 2023. Mobile internet users usage stats in India. Mobile internet users in 2017, 450 million, which corresponds very nicely to the 462 million internet users, which means an overwhelming majority of the people in India use the internet on their phones. Very strong smartphone adoption in India. India has already overtaken the US to become the second largest smartphone market in the world. And the implication of this is that businesses don't need to assume that their target audience or consumers would not be having smartphones and would be using feature phones, etc. So pretty much they can assume that people would be using their mobile apps with all the features possible. Platform users worldwide, Facebook is leading at 2.07 billion over WhatsApp, which is 1 billion. And interestingly, Instagram at 800 million is taking a very impressive lead as compared to LinkedIn and Twitter. I mean, 2017 has been a very good year for Instagram in terms of users. In India, the story is different. The leader is not what I meant is Facebook and WhatsApp are neck to neck in terms of the number of users, and in terms of the time spent, WhatsApp would have already overtaken Facebook. So the others, Twitter is not showing a great performance. Way behind as compared to Facebook and WhatsApp. These are the top five websites in India by category in banking, right? And shopping and news sites. Some important and interesting e-commerce trends. Cash on delivery remains the most preferred online payment method. We are not really a credit card strong economy in terms of the numbers, and majority of the online purchases happen during business hours, which means people use the corporate networks to do e-commerce transactions. And the industry is, as a whole, is growing at a very big rate, the e-commerce industry in India. These are the top categories of online shopping. For men, it's consumer electronics. For women, is lifestyle. So what are the main the new innovations which can be expected on the digital front in 2018? The first one is augmented and virtual reality. The Pokemon game actually introduced a lot of people to what augmented reality is all about. And now there are a lot of different devices in the market. There's Samsung Gear, Microsoft's HoloLens, which are trying to make this a more mass oriented and trying to reduce the prices of these devices. Quantum computing, the applications would be more high end and of course not used by a lot of businesses, but the main applications would be around cryptography and internet security. Those would be the first set of industries to touch quantum computing. A lot of hype around blockchain, more actually hype around the cryptocurrency, but although cryptocurrency could be an hype, the underlying technology behind it, which is blockchain, is definitely not a hype. And quite a few companies and organizations, like for example NASDAQ, is going to launch a ledger technology based on blockchain. Even SBI has taken some very firm steps in this direction. A very very likely to hit the marketing departments in a big way. One of the first ways would be through chatbots, which is expected to save a lot of money for businesses and is showing good growth already. Right, so those were the digital stats. Those are a summary of the digital stats for India and from a digital marketing point of view. Thank you.